Good morning, everybody. Welcome behind the scenes here at Jamie Riddler Studios. I am Jamie, and it is Friday, and I feel a little bit almost like calling this a gratitude Friday because I am just feeling, I don't know, you know, that tenderness of when you realize the blessings you have and you kind of really let them into your heart, the tenderness of even the hard things that make you realize the blessings that you have. Do you have those moments? I'm just feeling that today. In part because it has been an incredibly amazing, busy week. As many of you know, this week was the launch of the Studio Yearbook. Yay! The summer edition. This is the second time we have been rolling out the yearbook for you. And the yearbook is a seasonal guided journal and also a memory keeper. It is a simple fill-in-the-blank space that you get to pour your creative heart into, and that also provides some structure for you to have some support for bringing your creativity to life. And you know, that's what we're all about here at Jamie Riddler Studios, helping you find the courage and the confidence to bring your creativity to life. And the yearbook is a great way to support a creative practice. It is easy, it is beautiful, it is memorable. And I'm gonna share with you at the end of today's BTS, a video from somebody who has been using the yearbook and what she thinks of it. I love being able to share that, and that when you hear her message, it's one of the things I am, oh my gosh, my heart is just full. One of the things, I found this on my desk. Okay, first of all, I don't know if you can notice, but it is a complete and utter mess in here. That's just what you can actually see. Yeah, I tend to do that when I'm in the midst of a big project. I just explode. Everything around me just gets chaotic. And I know that it should actually be the opposite. You know, that the busier you are, the more structure you can bring underneath, the more order you can bring, the more peace you can bring, the more it nourishes you. But I have not managed that. Every single time, if I have a project, every single time I'm trying to improve the flow of it. I'm trying to learn from the last one. I'm trying to learn from the one I'm in so that next time I can do a better job and find more ease or more joy or reach more people or find a better way to express. I'm always looking for the way to be a better and better channel for the work that wants to come through me. And right now, the work that wants to come through me seems to be a bit of like a wild hurricane. And that results in a bit of chaos. Having said that, one of the things that can be a great joy about that is yesterday at about 4 o'clock, all of the first 100, which is what we call the Studio Yearbook hard copies, are sold out, and PDFs are still available, and there's lots of time for you to get your PDF and have it printed in just the way you like it, so you're ready to start your yearbook on the first day of summer. Isn't that fun to celebrate the summer solstice that way? But yesterday around 4 o'clock, I just took a moment and I was so excited to tidy my room, not this room, obviously, and to do my laundry. And it's a great reminder sometimes that those regular things about life, those everyday things, can be a great blessing. Anyway, what I was going to say was I have this piece of paper on my desk because one of the things we do in the yearbook is every day we have a little spot to create words from the day. And often they're things I overhear or a great line from a show I'm watching, some words in a book that really touched me, something funny I heard someone said. And I kept this one, and I did not credit it. I usually like to credit it. If there's not a credit, it usually means I overheard it. And oh, I know where this was from. This was from, I'm in Carla Sondheim's 365 class this year, and yesterday she shared a video with a creative person. And one of the things he said was, be one of those people on which nothing is lost. Be one of those people on which nothing is lost. Pay attention. Pay attention to your life. Pay attention to yourself. Pay attention to the human beings you encounter. We forget that one. We think about paying attention to beauty. We think about paying attention to our intuition, paying attention to the universe, paying attention to signs. But often we forget to pay attention to others, and not just our loved ones, which yes, do, please, very important. But also, you know, the bus driver or the person you're passing on the street or the person that gave you your coffee. Pay attention. Be one of those people on which nothing is lost. Notice the blessings. Notice the ironies. Notice the humor. Notice the meaning. Pay attention. Now, I have to, of course, say something for you HSCs. Do you remember what that means? Highly sensitive creatives. For you highly sensitive creatives, sometimes we pay attention so deeply, we get exhausted. I was like that when Justin and I traveled to France, which was a dream come true for me. And we were in Paris, and I was just on high sensitivity alert all the time. You know, what do they mean when they say that? Where are the instructions? How do you order there? Where do you go? Do you go left or right? What is the price? Like, just trying to understand this world that I was in turned me into this feeling ball of sensitivity, and nothing was lost on me. And that was a bit exhausting. I feel that ties to me too. Also, you know, when you hear people really talk about not having an ego, like your ego's getting in the way, don't let your ego take charge, turn down that ego, let go of your ego. One of the things I often think about that is you have to have established your ego first before you let it go. You have to have had the chance to know who you are and make your own decisions and find your own way. And maybe, yes, get a little pigheaded about it, bullheaded about it. Get strong in that sense of identity before you can let it go. I heard a word that I loved more than balance. Balance doesn't strike the right chord for me. But I heard a word recently, buoyancy. And I like the feel of that. It brings to mind resilience, which I think is one of the greatest skills we can have as a creative being. Because as a creative, we open up to the world. We don't let things get lost on us. We notice and savor color and words and relationships and connections. And we open up. And yes, that makes us vulnerable. And then we create something. And then sometimes we share it. And maybe people like it. Maybe people don't like it. Maybe people give us a hard time. Maybe people slam it. And that's vulnerable. Okay, let's just go back to that buoyancy thing for a minute, right? Being up enough to feel confidence moving forward and creating, to feel engaged and excited about life, to feel brave enough to create and courageous enough to share. This is like all this kind of energy. And then also to be grounded, to be realistic enough to know what the given circumstances are, to be in the earth of real life, to make from what you do have, not obsess with what you don't, to always be growing and also improving, so that when you do get slammed back and someone doesn't like something you do or gives you some negative feedback, that you can take a moment and say, is there truth in this? Is there something for me to learn in this? What can I offer in the face of this? And to not get all shut down, but instead to fix what's broken and let go what doesn't belong to you. And I find that each time, let's say each time I create something, there's some negatives along the way. Maybe a little bit of negative feedback, somebody who's not happy about this, a place I notice something's not working, a ball gets dropped, I miss something, a mistake gets made. Yesterday I made a mistake when I sent out the newsletter to the studio members to let them know that the yearbook was available. And I forgot to put the studio code in it. Now the studio code is available other places, but I like to give it to people. I don't want people to miss out on the savings you get with the code. So I resent the email with the discount code inside. And I got some negative feedback about filling people's inboxes. And I had to stop and think and really know in my heart whether I was in integrity about that. Because this is the key, I find, that the more in integrity you are, the more confident you are in what you're doing, the more buoyant you are, the more resilient you are, and the more you get knocked off balance, you know, is when you're unsure. When you're unsure whether you did it right, whether you're unsure you feel good about it. And that is natural. I have felt like that millions of times. It's only through feeling like that that I've gotten to be able to make changes, make adjustments, hone something until I feel like, no, this is good. Like this is, yeah, actually this is the policy I'm going to have around that. Actually, yeah, no, this is how I'm going to respond to things like that. No, this is what we do here in the studio. And you might like it and it feels like home to you. Awesome. I'm so glad you're here. And it might not appeal to you, and that's okay. I hope you find the thing that does feel like home to you. I am at peace with, I am in integrity with my experience and what's in my heart. And it takes a while to get there, and it takes getting it wrong, messing it up. And it takes being vulnerable and open to feedback. Feedback from people, feedback from systems, feedback from situations, feedback from your gut, your instincts, feedback from the universe. And don't let that feedback be lost on you. Course correct. Rest. Like, give yourself a chance to recuperate from that. It is not easy. You know, this is what I always say is the best way to follow your path. It's not about seeing the whole thing at the beginning. It's not about knowing with surety and clarity your life purpose and exactly who you are and what you're meant to be, because I don't think we know all those things till the very end of our days. But it is about tuning into yourself, knowing your inner compass, looking out there in the world, it's always over there to me, having your eye on the prize, a desire, a something that you want to see, be, experience, and taking a step towards it, noticing what happens, doing a gut check. Does this feel right? Is this going well? What's the world telling me about this? Do I still want this? Readjusting. Check your inner compass. Eye on the prize. Maybe it's moved. Maybe it's over here now. Take a step. It's the way of living a creative adventure. You will find more magic, more truth, more serendipity this way than picking something and plowing through. At least that's been my experience. So that's what's going on in the studio. It's been all yearbook all the time. I am deep in this sense of blessing. I'm inspired by this idea of buoyancy, of lifting ourselves up and moving forward while staying rooted and grounded and moving with the energy of ourselves, our lives, and what we're creating, not being so rigid that we have no flexibility and we're not alive to this moment. Be alive to this moment. I hope you have a wonderful weekend in your studio. Remember, your life is your studio. I'll see you on Tuesday.
I love the yearbook because it has so far helped me really celebrate the spring, really express myself and develop a creative practice, and use all my fun tools and supplies and play every single day. I can't say enough. I just love it. It's now a part of my everyday life that I look forward to. And I also love reading my yearbook. I love going back and looking at the treasures that are in it. I can't believe how much happens in a very short time. I mean, one day contains so many treasures. And it's wonderful to have a record of those treasures. You know, just all the little tiny things that you think you'll always remember, and there they are. So I'm thrilled. I absolutely adore it.
Trees, and under those trees my mom planted daffodils. I just love them. Mom, I planted these for you.